Hey fam, I want you to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/ Roland S. Martin. And don't forget to turn on your notifications.
Martin. Conservative Political Action Committee opened their big conference here in the D.C. area. And Van Jones, of course, was there to talk about criminal justice reform. This was part of that conversation today.
The conservative movement in this country, unfortunately, from my point of view, is now the leader on this issue of reform in that you look at Mississippi, a rock rib, totally conservative, former jailer is the governor there, Governor Bryant. Governor Bryant has cut the prison population and crime at the same time. Deal in Georgia cut the prison population and crime at the same time. Rick Perry cut the prison population, prison expenditures, and crime at the same time. Ohio, South Carolina, what you're seeing now are Republican governors being tough on the dollars, tough on crime, and shrinking prison populations and showing the rest of the country that it can be done. Now, my problem is I now have a conservative movement that for libertarian reasons, for Christian conservative reasons, and for fiscally conservative reasons, is actually doing a great job on what should be my issue. This is supposed to be my issue. You are stealing my issue. So,
so they're welcoming you. Why do they keep going?
Look, I'm going to stay in my party. But what I want to say, but take some dadgum credit for being smart. Take some dadgum credit for getting it right, and take some dadgum credit for showing that, listen, if you take some food, we had this conversation before.
Yeah, don't take my food.
I'm a socialist, according to you. I should take your food. I'm just joking.
We probably don't want to go there either.
That's good. But listen, here's what happened, and you guys understand how this happens. We passed a bunch of laws 30 years ago, throwing the book at everybody for everything. And then we didn't look at it again. A lot of people didn't. It's just like when you get food, you go out to eat, you get a bunch of food, you put it in the refrigerator, look at it for 3 weeks, 6 weeks, you open that up, it doesn't look like food anymore.
All right, so let me unpack this, okay, or let me deconstruct this. I know Van very well. We've collaborated on various issues when the First Step Act was being looked at by Congress, when that was being driven through the House, Congressman Hakeem Jeffries and others. I was certainly supportive of that because I agree with Van that when the people who are in federal prisons, there needs to be reform. Here's what he was saying, how I would have said it. First of all, he is correct in that you have Republican governors who have decided to step up when it comes to jail reform. 7 years ago, a top civil rights leader told me where I was speaking at a banquet in the Midwest. He said that we have been able to move the needle more with Republican governors than Democrats. But you have to provide context. Why is that the case? It's because Democrats have always been labeled as soft on crime. Republicans have always run on tough on crime. And so as a result, if you were a Democrat who ran for district attorney, or you ran for a judicial position, or you ran for a state position as governor, you had to prove to largely white conservative voters that you were tough on crime. I'm born and raised in Texas. I remember when Mark White was running for re-election, and he was in a studio, and there literally were posters that were three times the size of him. And he was walking through, and it was all of these photos of largely black and brown people and a few white people. And they were photos of people who he said Texas put to death. This week, Texas will put to death the 560th person since the Supreme Court allowed the death penalty to be reinstated. Mark White was a Democrat. Mark White was saying, I'm a Democrat, but I can be tough on crime with putting in the death. And so that's the reason why you had Democrats who are running. You're seeing it right now, Senator Kamala Harris. Oh, how is she a criminal justice? Because when Democrats run for the attorney general, the district attorney, oh, what are the white conservatives going to say? I need to appeal to their votes. So here's what you had here. And we dealt with this issue years ago on my show, Washington Watch, on TV One. I had a brother who was on the show who was upset when I pointed this out about these conservative governors. And he said, well, they're doing this for financial reasons. He was making the moral argument. I said, bruh, it doesn't matter if you're making the moral argument, if they're making the fiscal conservative argument, if this decreases the number of jails, the people in prison, I'm down with it. See, that's what Van did not unpack. Now, Van said conservatives are leading the criminal justice reform movement. No, that's a lie. Conservatives have separated jail reform and criminal justice reform. Criminal justice reform is a much larger umbrella. Now, Van knows this. He works with groups right now. He's the CEO of the group that they just launched with Meek Mill and Robert Kraft, who gonna need their help because he got charged with prostitution. And so I understand his point. But the reality is, conservatives are not leading the criminal justice reform movement. It is, in fact, progressives and liberals. It's black people and brown people who are actually leading the criminal justice reform movement. Because when you talk criminal justice reform, it's not just about jails and who is going to jail. It's also about the sentences that are being handed out in these state courts. It's about who the district attorneys are. It's about repealing the folks who are in jail on marijuana convictions. It's also about how we are dealing with suspensions in schools and a school-to-prison pipeline. Criminal justice reform cannot just be seen through the prism of jails. It's also bail reform. It's a much wider issue. And so when conservatives, when Republicans, as a national party, puts criminal justice reform in their plank, then we can talk about it. If you have more governors who go beyond just the fiscal reason for jail reform, then we can have the conversation. But see, Van, I could not be like you and sit in a room of conservatives and say they have been smart on this when in fact you still have too many Republicans who tried to block the First Step Act, who tried to block criminal justice reform. You still have the Senator Tom Cotton of the world from Arkansas. You still have Jeff Sessions who blocked it with DOJ. You still have folks who are putting these things in place. The reality is Bob McCulloch was thrown out in St. Louis and replaced by progressive Wesley Bell. Larry Krasner became the DA in Philadelphia. You, of course, have Marilyn Mosby in Baltimore. You have, of course, Amalia in Aramis down in Florida. So you got black folks. You got now Justice Creuzeau, former judge in Dallas, who's now the DA. You now have progressive-minded district attorneys who are starting from a position of, we're not going to throw everybody in jail. This is my issue, Van. If conservatives are actually leading the movement, and I understand Trump signed the First Step Act and what he touted, but has Donald Trump reversed all of the actions of Jeff Sessions that he put in place when he became Attorney General? The answer is no. Has Donald Trump and Jared Kushner and Republicans reversed it when they said we're going to go back to private prisons? No, they have not done that. Jeff Sessions told his prosecutors to stop doing what Eric Holder said, and that is don't go for the maximum. He said, no, you go for the maximum sentences you can actually impose. And so I am not going to somehow say that conservatives are leading a criminal justice reform movement when the proof simply is not there. Just because a governor in Mississippi and a governor in Texas, and just because a governor in Kansas, they have made those decisions, and a governor in Georgia, they still are fundamentally have bad policy overall when it comes to criminal justice reform. The day when the Republican National Committee and Republicans in the House and Republicans in the Senate and the Republican Governors Association and the Republican, all of their various groups, the day when they as a party stands up and says that we are fully backing criminal justice reform on every single level, then
I will say that's what they're doing. But there's no way in hell I will say that and give them cover when the very people who are at CPAC are the same folks who are going to go home and do what they do. Governor Abbott of Texas, he needs to step up and pardon Crystal Mason, who was put in prison for 5 years for voting when she didn't realize she could not vote and she lost her job and she also had a family. Show me, please, when they are going to do more than just confront what's happening in jails. You had better deal with what's happening of throwing people in prisons, what's happening with juveniles, what's happening in high schools and middle schools and elementary schools. I am not going to give somebody credit for a small piece of criminal justice reform. No, you're going to have to do a hell of a lot more than that. Van, you my boy, but you wrong. And you were wrong for giving them that comfort. And what you should have done, Van, is challenge them to do more. What you should have said is, here are your marching orders. What you should have said that if you are real and true about criminal justice reform, do this, 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 and this. The damage has been done because of conservative policies, and Democrats went along with that crap because they were scared to be called weak on crime. No, you are not getting off that easy, CPAC, or the GOP, or Trump. You got a hell of a lot more work to do than what you've done thus far. Final comment from our panelists.
I think you nailed it. There's not much else to say, but I will say one word.
Exactly.
I said because Willie Horton. Let's just see, but what has happened is these conservatives do racial manipulation to make people frightened of black people, and then the Democrats are supposed to be so soft on crime, as you said, and so they don't say anything. Willie Horton was an aberration, but Willie Horton was used to win an election. And we've seen cards like that played time and time and time again. And so Van was playing Mr. Bojangles for the white folks. I hope he was paid well.
Well, you know, here's the deal. I understand he worked with Jared Kushner and the folks with the First Step Act. He's absolutely right what those individual states have done. But again, that was largely jail reform. Republicans initially wanted jail reform. It was Hakeem Jeffries and Senator Cory Booker and Senator Dick Durbin who pushed them saying, no, this thing has got to be broader than that. And I'll give it, Senator Chuck Grassley, Republican of Iowa, even said, that's not good enough. But I'm not going to say without the proof, show me where they are leading, Erica, because I'm not seeing that. It's too many young folks and too many black folks and Latino folks who are in the streets right now. If conservatives are leading the criminal justice reform movement, I want to see when they march it in Chicago against cops.
Well, we won't see it, but we will continue to see commentary about Chicago. For that statement to be made next to Matt Schlapp, whose wife Mercedes Schlapp works in the White House, to crown conservatives, so to speak, as being kings and queens of criminal justice reform was irresponsible at the best.
Scott?
I'm still trying to figure out how you reduce prison population and reduce crime at the same time. Those statistics have to be checked. I'm not ready to crown them either, given their history. And I think you nailed it when you said, don't give them too much history. This was a financial decision, prison reform, and these private prisons that have been costing states all over this country millions and millions of dollars. And for what? To house these prisons and to build new prisons. And they used to argue that it was about the jobs, not about housing black and brown people. So I think there's even more unpacking to do, Roland.
And again, I will give you credit where credit has been earned.
Right.
But I'm not going to say they are leading the criminal justice reform movement because that is not what is going on.
Right.
And that First Step Act was about that big. Important, but it was that big. Mm-hmm. Remember, you had Democrats who wanted a much larger criminal justice reform bill. Republicans said, no, that's going a little too far.
First Step
just so we know.
First Step represents about 5% of what needs to be done, about 5%.
But also it's called the First Step, which means, damn it, it's a second and a third. Show me where that bill is.
Exactly.
Right?
I was about to say,
where's
that pending?
I'm waiting on. That's all I'm waiting on.
And what are they going to do about the killing fields of Chicago?
That's all I'm waiting on. No. I ain't going
to
use Chicago. What are they going to do about
killing fields of D.C.?
No. What are they going to do about all these different cities?
Mm-hmm.
Again, they are not leading the criminal justice reform movement.
Right.
I'm not going to give folks that. But y'all can. Yeah. Oh, no. You got an opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Just legalize marijuana. Yeah.
Let's see if you do it. Let's see if you do it.
All right. All right, folks. Back to our Roland Martin Unfiltered video in just one moment.
Calling all HBCU alumni, students, and leaders. Enter the Ford Motor Company HBCU Mobility Challenge and win $25,000 for your school. Building on their long-term support of HBCUs, Ford is looking to improve mobility in HBCU communities through innovative solutions. The winning program will receive a grant of up to $25,000 to implement the proposal. The deadline to apply is March 31st, 2019. We want you to go to fgb.life, fgb.life, for more information and to apply. Ford goes further in our community, and we certainly appreciate Ford Cares being a partner here at Roland Martin Unfiltered. Okay, now back to your Roland Martin Unfiltered video.